Hi everyone, this is Nia and today I'm going to be painting a cozy tea time doodle. This was one of those unplanned doodles and I just placed whatever items I can think of. So let's get right into it by sketching it out. The first thing that I want to draw out at the center, which will be the focal point of this doodle, is a teapot serving a cup of tea. At this point, I wasn't really sure about the size and things, so you can see that my sketches are quite light and a bit scratchy since I was still trying to figure things out along the way. Whenever I'm sketching, I like to hold my pencil quite high, and this also helps with the looseness of the sketch, so it's much easier to erase the unclean lines without damaging the paper because we're not putting too much pressure as we draw, which can dig and damage the paper. This is how I'm going to treat the other items as well. My aim here is just to drop down my ideas as quickly as possible on paper without focusing too much on the details. Since it's the season to be cozy, I also wanted to include fall desserts on top of the usual afternoon tea menu like cakes and biscuits. So here I'm just going to add things like apple pie, a jar of preserves or a jar of jam and things like that. Like usual when I'm drawing out these items, I like to simplify the shapes. So I try to figure out what the basic shape for a certain item is. In this case, for this jam, after I figure out where to place the lid, I just basically drew out a rectangle and then I tried to connect the lines together. And this is basically how I approach drawing most of the items here. The reason why I'm sketching very quickly and roughly is also because of time reason. Since this is the sketching portion, there might still be times where I have to erase and reposition certain items. And by not putting too much effort and time to draw each item, there's basically no time wasted when I need to erase a whole item that I've already drawn. And personally, I just find that this is a much more efficient approach. So here, since I already know I'm going to place the milk here, but I felt like the bottle was a little bit too small, and I also want to tilt it the other way around because I find that this will suit the composition better. And even after I erased it, I didn't really regret drawing the previous one because I didn't really waste too much time on it. So I'm just going to continue to draw out the rest of the items while also moving things around or repositioning them until I'm happy with the composition. After I filled the page with most of the items, I want to add some fillers like leaves and flowers just to get rid of those random and awkward spaces. And I'm also going to draw them lightly so I don't forget to paint them later on. After that, I'm going to clean out the drawing, especially for the items that I feel uncomfortable with outlining without clean lines. But for some of them, I feel like I have enough indication for me to outline with pen, even if it's still a mess, so I'm just going to leave it as is. However, I think you guys know your comfort zones better than I do, so feel free to clean out the outline as best as you can before lining them with ink according to your own levels. But like usual, I'll also have the outline available in my coffee shop if you want to get straight to painting. So once I'm ready, I'm just going to outline with my pen, and this is my Unipen Fine Line in the size 0.1. The color is this light brown, which is lighter than my usual Sakura Micron pen in the color Sepia. And basically, I'm just going to neaten the outline and fix things along the way as I draw them out. However, as I was outlining the apple pie, I forgot about the weaving that I wanted to create, so I ended up making a mistake and drawing over the lines, creating the checker pattern instead, but I'll fix it later on as I paint. And from here, I'm just going to continue to outline the rest of the items. Usually, if I were to take a bit more time on this, I would actually leave the outlining last because I find that certain areas after I paint, if I paint using a darker value, I wouldn't need to add as much outline as this. But I wanted this to be a quick doodle, and it's much easier to paint on a surface that is already outlined, so the edges are much cleaner. And this is up to you how you would like to approach this doodle. You can approach it like my other doodles that I paint before outlining, or you can approach it this way. After I'm done outlining, I'm going to erase the scratchy pencil sketch underneath all of the items, and I ended up outlining the pattern on the teapot as well. I left it out for last because I wasn't sure if I wanted to paint it without the outline before. As for the colors, I'll be using Ultramarine Finest by Schmincke, Indigo by Schmincke, Hans Yellow Medium by Daniel Smith, Gray of Gray by Holbein, Yellow Ochre by Holbein, Chinese White by Holbein, Windsor Red by Winsor & Newton, Burnt Umber by Holbein, and I'll also be using Bleedproof White by Dr. Paige Martens. As for the pen, this is the UniPen Fine Line in the size 0.1, and this is the one that I used to create the outline earlier. So I think we're ready to paint. The first color I'm going to create is a neutral creamy color, and this is from a mix of yellow ochre and gray of gray mixed with Chinese white depending on how light you want the color to be. I also added a lot of water, so I'm using a thin consistency. With this light creamy color, I'm going to use to paint the base color for both of the tea bags, and I'm just going to paint them with a flat wash. To paint the tags, I want this to be a bit more neutral, so I added a bit more gray of gray into the ratio, so the tone is slightly different. And as for the side of the tea bag, I want to use a darker version of the same color, so I use a ratio with less Chinese white. Same with this jar of sugar. For the bottom part or part of the jar, I'm going to use the lighter version, and for the lid or the top part, I'm using the darker value. I'm also going to use the same color for the ramekin. For the lids of the jar at the bottom, I'm just using yellow ochre by itself to create a golden lid, and I'm using gray of gray for the tin of the apple pie. For the glass jars, this includes the milk as well as the honey jar and the jam jar. I'm going to use the same creamy color, but with added gray of gray. You can always adjust the ratio to your liking, but I'm just going to paint them in the same way by painting the jar only and avoiding whatever is inside of it. Next, I'm going to paint the lemons. And I'm going to create a different color from Hans Yellow, Yellow Ochre, and Chinese White. The reason why I added yellow ochre is because I want the color to be a little bit more neutral and muted to fit the cozy mood that I'm trying to depict. I'm using a really light consistency for the inside of the lemon. And as for the rind, I'm using the mix without Chinese white, so that's just yellow ochre and Hansi yellow. As for the darker value at the bottom, I added more yellow ochre to the ratio. I also added a bit of texture by dotting in a light consistency toward the center of the lemon using Hansi yellow. Then with a clean damp brush, I pulled some light yellow color across to the white areas of the lemon, so it's very pale instead of it being completely white. I'm basically going to do the same thing with a couple of lemon slices here. And this time, since there's more of the rind showing, while applying the darker value with the yellow ochre and the Hansi yellow, I also exaggerated the color by adding a touch of Windsor red to make it more orangey. And as I applied it, I created these dots, which I softened later on with a clean damp brush, while I still have a touch of Hansi yellow in my brush to create the uneven surface of the lemon rinds. This time I'm also creating a slight gradient towards the center of the lemon just for a bit of variation. So at the center, I use a slightly thicker consistency and I just soften the blend. Now moving on to the biscuits, I'm actually going to use the same color mixture as the lemon rind, but this time I added much more yellow ochre with a bit more Windsor red. This way I can create more of a golden brown color. I'm also going to apply the same color for the apple pie, since this is also a baked pastry crust. Once I'm done, I'm going to move on to paint the honey inside of the honey jar. And for this, I'm basically using the same mixture, but I added more Hansi yellow to make it less orangey. But for the bottom part, to create a bit more depth, I used the previous golden brown color. As for the top section, I'm going to use a thin consistency of Hansi yellow because that's where usually the light is hitting it from. Next, I'm going to use the same area of color on my palette. This time, I'm adding a bit more Windsor red. And this is to create an orange color, which I'm going to use to paint the base color of the pumpkin. Once I'm done covering the whole surface, and while the surface is still a little bit damp, I'm going to create a darker value which has more Windsor red in the ratio, and I'm just going to dot it in for the bottom and also the back of the pumpkin, and I'm just going to let them mingle with each other, creating a soft transition between those two colors for a bit of variation. I'm also going to use the Hansi yellow I still have on my palette to paint the flower on the right hand side, and then I added a bit of indigo to create this green for the leaves. Now moving on to the spoon on the right, I just used gray of gray, and for the coffee stir or the tea stir, I'm going to use the same golden brown color. Next, I'm going to use burnt umber with a bit of the yellow that I had on my palette to dot in the tea leaves as just a little bit of texture, and I'm leaving out a lot of negative space here and there because I want to include other colors. I'm also going to do this for the other tea bag, and I'm using a medium to light consistency because I'm going to be layering a thicker consistency of the same color on top for a bit more depth. After painting on some of the tea leaves, I'm going to go over the right-hand side of the triangular tea bag using the same neutral creamy color from earlier, but you do have to make sure that the tea leaves are completely dry. For the filling of the apple pie, I used the green for the leaves with added yellow ochre in the mixture to create this brownish green color, and I just painted in between the pastry. And here I'm reusing the golden brown color, but I added a bit of burnt umber to create a darker value, and I just used burnt umber for the darker holes. As you can see, I just keep using or adding colors to the colors I already have on my palette. And this is good practice for you to adjust visually without thinking of certain equations to color mixing. So as for the red, I picked up some of the mid-tone brown that I already have on my palette and mix it with the Windsor red to create something a bit more rich. This is something that you can practice with when you're doing these doodles because you don't really have to focus too much on layering and things like that, and it's fairly simple. You're basically just coloring in certain items. So feel free to play around with different ratios to create different colors. Anyway, moving on to the next color mixture. This is a mix of burnt umber and indigo to create a really dark brown, and the more indigo you use in the ratio, the darker the brown will be. As for this red gem, it's basically the same red as the cookie, and I'm basically reusing the colors that I already have for the cake as well. But remember that you can always customize the flavor of your cakes. So for example, you can create a strawberry cake or a blueberry cake and so on. While applying the second layer for the cake, I decided to use the tip of my brush to dot and create an uneven texture. And for the side of the cream of the cake, I use a mix of yellow ochre and Chinese white. While I wait for those colors to dry, I'm going to move on to paint the darker values of the jam cookies. And for this, I used a mix of Windsor red, burnt umber, and yellow ochre. After painting on the darker values, I can see that there's a lot of contrast between the dark value and the lighter value. So after this, I'm going to go over the lighter value again. Basically the same mixture, but with added yellow ochre to create more of a golden brown. And just like the cake, I'm going to use the tip of my brush to just dot the color around. And I'm also going to increase the vibrancy of the color for the apple pie as well. Next, I'm going to paint the strawberry jam, and for this I used a mix of Windsor red and Hansa yellow for the base color. After that, I'm going to start painting the cup as well as the teapot. For this, I used the creamy color mixture from earlier, but my brush still has a bit of the red from the jam, which is why this creamy color has a slightly different hue. I decided I quite like this color, so I'm going to create something similar for the teapot, which is the creamy color with a bit of Windsor red to create the pink, and also a touch of yellow ochre to make it a bit more peachy. As for the lid, I decided to make a slightly different color, so here I added Hansa yellow and also yellow ochre for a pastel golden color. Moving on to the pattern of the teapot, for the berries, I used Windsor red with a touch of indigo and burnt umber. As for the leaves, I just used the greens that I already had on my palette, and I used the mix of Hansa yellow and yellow ochre for the dots. As for the darker values for the color of the teapot and also the sides of the lid, I basically used the same color mixture but with less Chinese white in the ratio. As for the saucer and the rest of the design for the cup, I decided to just use the colors that I've already pre-mixed beforehand. For these flowers, it's up to you what color you want to use, but for me, I use a thick consistency of indigo because I felt like introducing more of the fall colors. I start to introduce a different tone of green for the rosemary, and this is basically the same mixture from Hansa yellow and indigo, but this has more indigo in the ratio to create a darker green. As for the blueberry jam, I used a mix of ultramarine finest with a little bit of crimson lake to create a bright purple color. But in this ratio, I added a bit more ultramarine finest, so it's more of a bluish purple. Since the milk is white, I don't want to leave it as a blank white area. Instead, I use a really thin consistency of gray of gray. I also decided to add a little bit of that light purple color from earlier to the tea bags, just to add another hue and make it a bit more colorful. You can also add a bit of green as the mixture of the tea. I also decided to add a bit of design for the tea bags and also the milk bottle. As for the milk bottle, I just use a mix of ultramarine finest with Chinese white. So I've basically painted most of the elements here, and I'm going to start painting on the filler flowers. For this, I used an orangey red, and this is from a mix of Windsor red with a touch of Hansa yellow. And I want this to be consistent all throughout the composition with the yellow center by using Hansa yellow by itself. Since I've painted all of the items, I'm just going to go over some of them again to add on details and things like that, such as the labels on the jam or the preserves, which I sadly didn't catch on camera. And I also added writing to the labels as well. So for the darker values of these items, I'm basically using the same mixture as the base, or more or less the same, with probably slightly different ratio, and I'm just using a darker version of it or a thicker consistency. Then, like the pumpkin here, I'm softening the blend to create a softer transition. Here I use a thick consistency of bleed-proof white to add the details for the scales of the mushrooms. And I also decided to cover the yellow dots for the teapot because I felt like it was looking a bit too dark and it needed a little bit of brightness from the white. And while I still have the bleed-proof white on my bristles, I ended up adding more highlights to the design of the berries on the teapot, as well as highlights for some of the items as well. Now this is where I'm going to fix the apple pie. I decided to go over those mistakes with bleed-proof white, so I'm essentially using whiteout to cover those areas. And I also decided to use a bit more red to glaze the apple pie because I felt like the green was a bit too muted and it doesn't have enough contrast to the pastry. And once the bleed-proof white is completely dry, I went over it with the pie color again to add the base color. Then I exaggerate the weave by using a darker value brown, and I just basically place them underneath the weaves. Since the bleed-proof white is quite opaque, I'm going to go over certain areas again, like the design of this teapot, since the white covered a lot of the outline. And once I'm done, I'm just going to add extra fillers, like more rosemary's here for some awkward spaces. Of course, you can vary the filler items as well, so I decided to add some purple flowers and also lavenders. When I was adding the final adjustments and final details, unfortunately my camera wasn't recording this, but I basically added dots using the same color as the base color for extra textures to some of the items like the cake, the tea bags, the cookies and biscuits, as well as the jam. Here I'm using my pen again to add extra details for the rim of the jar or the bottle, and a little bit of dots facing the center for the lemon as well, using a mix of Hans yellow and a bit of yellow ochre. I'm also going over the blueberries using a thicker consistency underneath to give them a rounder form. I'm going back in with my pen again to add extra details, but you can go as far as you would like. And that's basically it for this painting. If you guys enjoyed the content that you see here, please consider subscribing for more like this. Like usual, the list of tools as well as my social media links will be in my description box. If you guys are still here, thank you so much for watching till the end, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!